Hello everyone, this is Sam Spade and welcome to another Coding Fundamentals and GML tutorial. In this tutorial, we're going to be talking about error messages. Error messages are built into GameMaker. They pop up after certain types of mistakes, and they provide you basic information about that mistake or error. They do generally crash your game, however, they're the easiest type of bug to fix. So in many ways, they're the best type of bug to have. An error message looks like this. The first part we'll look at is this stack frame down here. Now we will have a tutorial on the call stack at some point, but for the moment, it's enough to know that this basically tells you where you are in the code and how you got there. If there were multiple script calls, it would show you the line of script calls that got you to the one that caused the problem. So it's extremely helpful to trace how you got to where the problem is in the code. This also tells you what object is causing the problem. In this case, object variables type scope. Note that GML will tack on GML object for objects. So this would be whatever you've named the object. And then this is GML's addition saying that it's a GML object. This is the create event and it's in line 10. Also tells you this in three places, here, here, and here. And then finally, it tells you what the actual error is. Object variable type scope dot player name not set before reading it. This is actually the same message that I used in the variable basics tutorial, and it's caused by referencing a variable before you set it. All right, let's switch over to GameMaker Studio 2 and see a couple of these in action. Okay, so I'm going to cause three different types of errors. The first one is the error that we were just looking at. I'm going to reference a variable that doesn't exist. So here we have player name equals link, and then we're going to say show debug message player name, but I've misspelled player name, so this variable doesn't actually exist. So we'll run it. All right, I've cut out the actual compile time. So here we have the error. So object error message, create event, that's where we are. Line 6, right here. That's where we're at in the call stack. And again, you can see fatal error in action number 1 of create event, object error messages. Object error message, player name, not set. Now obviously in this case, I've done it on purpose, but it's not actually that hard or that uncommon even to misspell a name. And GameMaker Studio 2 actually has a really nice feature, which is this yellow warning sign that says variable player name only referenced once, or player name, I guess. And that's strange because it shouldn't be referenced once, it should be referenced again right here. So we can click abort, we can fix this, and now that message goes away because now it's being referenced twice. Okay, let's run this again and get the next error. Okay, so here we have the next error. Again, here's where we are in the call stack. Here's where the error message occurred, and this is the type of error message. We have an out of range reference on our array. So we can see that's in line 10. Here we go. Array 5. So we're trying to reference the fifth position. But remember, because arrays are zero indexed, this is actually the sixth position. And there's only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 things in our array. So we're actually trying to reference what's right here. That doesn't exist. So we're getting an out of range error. We can fix this by going like this. And now it will be in range. All right, let's see another type of error here. Okay, here we're referencing an instance that does not exist. And actually, I've made the classic mistake of confusing object and instance over here. This should say referencing an instance that does not exist. The object does exist. Object data type is a real object. It's in our resource tree over here. Object data type, so here it is. But there's no instance of it in our room. So we're trying to reference it, and it doesn't work. So that's the first thing we can learn from this. The second thing we can see is that now we actually have two lines in this call stack. So we can see object error message. That was the first thing, but that's not actually where the error is. It is in script print first name. So here's our script print first name. You can go into it. You can go into it by clicking the middle mouse button. And now we can see show debug message argument 0 first name. So we're passing in an argument, that argument is an object ID, and then we're trying to get the first name of that object ID, but no instance of it exists, and so we are getting an error message. And again, note that the error message tells us that it occurs in this script, but this script is being called by this object in this event. So print first name is the script, line 6 right here, but it's being called from the create event of object error message, line 14 right here. And this, of course, is very helpful because you might have multiple objects or instances of objects calling the same script. So you don't want to just know what script is being called, where that script is, where the error is in the script. You want to know which instance of an object is calling that script. One last thing to demonstrate about error messages here is you can always do copy, and then you could paste the error message into Notepad or text or into the forums or something like that. This can make it a little bit easier to read. Sometimes these error messages go way off over here. So copy and paste can be a nice way to get and save that information for later if you need it. The next thing I want to talk about are error messages in debug mode. Debug error messages look a little bit different, but they provide the same information. And more importantly, the debugger stops the code on the line that causes the problem, which allows you to inspect and debug those values. So I'm going to switch back over to GameMaker Studio 2 and demonstrate that. I'm going to cause the same error that we had before, where this is now going to be out of bounds, and I'm going to run it in the debugger. Okay, so we've got the same error that we got before, but now, as you can see, it looks a little bit different. You can still copy it if you want to, but the button's gone. More importantly, though, it stopped us here, and we can inspect the various variables that exist. So we can see player name equals link. We can see that there's an array. We can come over here to our array. We can look at those values, and we could even count them and go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Know that that's the fourth index. And here we're referencing 6, so that's 2 out of bounds. If you can create the error message regularly, running the game with the debug mode and stopping on that line and inspecting the values is a great way to help yourself debug and figure out what's going on, what's going wrong with your code. And finally, I want to talk about custom error messages. GameMaker Studio 2 allows you to write your own error messages using the built-in function showError. Showerror allows you to specify the message that you get and also allows you to specify whether it will crash or abort the game or whether you can ignore it and continue. Like I said at the start, error messages are probably the most useful form of debugging because they tell you what the problem is and where that problem is. And these are two key things you have to know to fix the problem. So creating your own error messages can be a very helpful method to test your own code, check to make sure you're not making mistakes when you're writing code, and so on. So I've created a very simple example script. Is the number 5? All it does is check to see whether or not the number you're passing is equal to 5. If it's not equal to 5, it's going to give us the error message, not the number 5, and it's not going to crash our game. And we'll see an example of that in just a moment. So here is the custom error message. As you can see, we got it on line 5 of script is the number 5, or line 7, and we got the message, not the number 5. And here we could choose to abort, or we could choose to ignore, and then we're going to go on and get our second error message because I didn't fix this line. So you can see that we didn't actually crash the game. The game kept going. And now we hit this error message, and this error message doesn't give us the option to ignore. This one, we have to abort, and the game ends. In summary, error messages are great because they're the easiest type of bug to fix. They tell you what is wrong and where it went wrong. Error messages in debug mode are even better because they allow you to inspect the values, and if you want, you can even create your own custom error messages to help you test and debug your code. As always, the links on this slide will be below, as well as a link to the slides themselves and a link to the source code. And that's it. Thanks for watching.